The distribute 2D random eye expression does exactly what its name says, namely, it distributes a bunch of 2D layers randomly in 2D space. And to see how this is working, I have prepared here already some shape layer, and I duplicated several times. So you can go to Edit Duplicate or Control D. And let's say I create here 20 points. And now I select all of them and apply this eye expression. And what you can see now is that they are all distributed in this area here, which is between point 0, 0 and 200, 100, because we gave this here as minimum value and maximum value. If you want them to be placed all over your composition, you can instead, of course, just say between 0, 0 and this point here, which is in my case 1280, 720. And if you reapply this, you see they are now randomly distributed all over, and currently they are not moving at all. Yeah, you can see if I'm going here over the timeline, they are perfectly static. If you want them to move also a bit, you can add some kind of wiggle. So we go here and say we want them to move, let's say 30 pixels in each direction. So we set amplitude to 30, and it should move rather slow, let's say one move every 0.2 moves per second, so to speak. And if we reapply this and now do a RAM preview, you can see that they are very gently, very slowly moving. Yeah, just a very subtle movement. If you want them to move faster, of course, you can either increase the frequency here or also the amount by which they are moving. Let's say they should move 300. Let's keep this here slow at 0.2. You can see now they are moving a bit more, namely 300 pixels in each direction, and one move takes around, or each second it takes, it does 0.2 moves. In other words, one full move takes around 5 seconds now. Okay, so by this you can really nicely place the elements. If you do not like this particular random placement, you can go here to the randomness and set another random seed. Yeah, so this means if I pick here, for example, 3 instead of 1, you will see the placement here will change, but in the general behavior nothing will change. Yeah, so still the points are moving like this. Another option that you have is to pick for every frame another random seed. This is here this change over time flag. And if you do this, let's also apply this here once, then the random placement changes for every frame. Yeah, so you can see here you have a new random behavior in every frame. Okay, another parameter, so let's undo these changes here, set this here also back to 1, and close this down. Another option that you also have is if you want to move individual points on top of their random placement. Yeah, it's like, okay, you have all these randomly placed points and now you want them to move also in certain directions or so. You can keyframe their position as usual if you enable this use keyframe value as offset here. So maybe let's just set here these wiggle behaviors also to 0 and now say use keyframe value as offset. If you apply this, you can see all elements are now again completely static. Oh, sorry, we haven't enabled this. So let's enable this and reapply. Now you've seen all elements are shifted by a certain amount here. And this amount by which it was shifted is exactly their position. So you can see to the position, the eye expression is applied, therefore it is red. But if you double click it, you can see this is the original keyframe value. Yeah, and if we set this to 0, 0, you can see this point just moved. Yeah, so let's do this for all the points, reveal all their positions by clicking P, So I select all their positions. And now I set this value to 0 and this value to 0. Yeah. Now if I look at any other, you can see they are all 0. And they are again nicely placed in the area that we want. This means the I expression distributes the points now randomly, but on top you can make them move. So let's say we want them to be at this position at keyframe or at frame number 10. Yeah. So therefore I can select these positions and set a keyframe and then say here at the beginning they should be moved in this direction. Yeah. So I just grab them and push them here in this direction. And now you can see on top of their random placement, we've done this keyframing here. Yeah? So this can always be done when you enable this use keyframe value as offset option. Remember that then if they should be placed in exactly the random position that was chosen by the I expression, you need them to have an initial position of 0. Okay, the last option that I want to show you is actually very powerful, and this is image-based probability. So let's deselect this option again and apply it. Now you can see the keyframes are again completely ignored and they are just placed randomly here. Yeah, so we can also disable the keyframes again. And what image-based probability allows you is to specify with another layer where your points should be placed. Let's see how this is looking like. We are creating a new solid and call this mat. And now we choose an image-based probability, say the layer, and you can either provide here a number or a name or an index of the layer where which tells us where to place the elements. Yeah. So in this mat layer, so I rename this here to mat. In principle, you could leave it at 1 because this mat layer is layer 1, but in case you want to move it later, I always like it better to choose the names here. And now let's enable this image-based probability and select the points and apply it again to them. You can see now that nothing happens, but if you now start modifying this mat layer, so let's say we take here an ellipse tool and I created another layer, a shape layer, which I actually didn't want, so my intention was to draw a mask on this mat layer. Let's make this mat layer here let's actually make it a bit transparent, like say 20% only, such as you can see the layers below. Yeah. If you now draw a mask on this layer, like this, you can see immediately all the elements are just placed within this area. Yeah. Let's better put this up again to 100 because maybe let's just make it invisible. Yeah, now you can start animating this mask. Can go here to the mask path and set here keyframe and now go to this position and go here. Yeah. And now if you look over time, the points will travel from this point, will be replaced randomly to always be inside of this mask. Yeah, this is a very convenient way to specify where your random points will be placed. And how this mat is working exactly, I make it visible again, is that in this mat layer, I've enabled here the solo mode for those, just a second. Okay, in this mat layer, it's such that the lighter a point in this mat layer is, the more likely is it that there is a point placed, yeah? In other words, white means very likely to place something here. Black means try by all means to avoid placing a random point here. And now I can even work with something like gradients. Yeah. So let's remove this mat here again and choose an effect, generate ramp. Where is it? Ramp here. And now you have such a ramp. And if I turn this layer again off, you can see, okay, there are some points here in the black area, on the darker areas, but most of the points are here in the white area. You notice it even better if I increase my number of points. So I select all of them and duplicate them. And maybe I even duplicate it a third time. So now we have really a bunch of layers, and you can see most of them are here in the top area, and only very few ones are in the dark area. Yeah, and this is corresponds exactly to the distribution that I have here in my gradient. And if I now modify my gradient, say the start of the ramp should be here, you can see all the points here adjusted accordingly. Yeah, so here in the black area, no points are placed, and between this and this, you have now a slow increase of the points. And now you can animate this over time to modify the random placement of your points. So a very convenient way to place layers just by coloring such a matte layer and choosing this in iExpressions here as your layer for image-based probability.